Caps and gowns seen across the five boroughs this week as the toughest school year in the nation's recent history comes to an end.
Well, there was the worry, the safety, but also they needed the structure and the teachers. Homeschooling was rough.
We are closing out the school year with 60% of New York City students learning remotely, but that option is off the table come September. The only time remote learning will continue is on snow days.
At this time, we aren't considering a remote option. You know, as a teacher and a mother, I know that the best learning happens between students and teachers in the classroom.
As for teachers, like Annie Tan, going back to the way things were pre-pandemic with crowded classrooms is the worry.
I'm worried about overcrowding, and I'm going back into the windowless classroom that I was teaching in March 2020 because there's no space in my building if everyone's coming back to the school building.
While parents are hoping for smaller class sizes, the teachers union is worrying about another shortage of educators. School Chancellor Misha Porter said she's confident that won't be happening again in New York City with the hiring of up to 1,000 teachers. After a heated ventilation debate, two delayed starts to the school year, and a roller coaster of building shutdowns due to positive cases, the mayor says we are ending the year with coronavirus almost non-existent in schools.
We've done 1.5 million COVID tests as of yesterday, 1.5 million COVID tests in our schools. Here is the latest number, COVID in the schools, 0.03%. So this is a testament to the vaccination effort.
And for the last day of schools, all the kids, in accordance with the CDC, had their masks on. But the mayor believes that mask mandate will not stick for September. We'll have to wait and see.